Hey tubers, I got a little bitty part here and another little bitty part right here. I don't know if you can see them, probably not. This is a oil pan drain plug, and this is the brass, or I don't know what, a copper maybe, the seal that goes around my nut, and I'm going to replace them. But there's only one way to do that. You guessed it, we gotta do an oil change. So I'm gonna do that, and let me get the camera set up. Be right back in just a jiffy. Okay tubers, I'm gonna try and use this adjustable wrench on here. I'm replacing this because somebody has mistreated it. I've said before, don't use the wrong wrench on your nuts. You need to hold them properly. If you don't hold your nuts properly, it tears them up. Hang on. You gotta hold them properly, or they just, you can't use them. If you don't have the right tool, go get it. See, I can't even do this. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. We'll try this with some channel locks. This just irritates me to no end. People mess up their nuts because they don't use the right wrenches. Use the right wrench. Golly, this irritates me. I didn't do this. Y'all know I didn't do it. All right, let's give this a go. There, that loosened it. God, dog it. Yeah, tubers, if you don't have the right wrench to fit on your nut, then go get one, go borrow one, something. Please. Okay. I'll be right back. I don't care about that nut falling on my string because it's going in the garbage. Be right back. Okay, tubers, look, we have the brand new plug, and we're going to screw it in here. If I can get it started. May not start. There it goes, just like that. And here, look at this, we've got an 1 1/8 wrench. It fits there perfectly, and we're gonna snug this up. Not going to mess it up with a wrench that doesn't fit. We're going to put it on there with a wrench that fits. And that's how you do that. If you don't have the right wrench for your nut, don't touch your nut. Okay, I'll be right back.
Okay, as most of y'all know, if you've been watching my stuff, I've got spin-on filters on all of my tractors. They've been converted. See. Ah. There we go. I don't like to use a wrench putting them on or taking them off. But of course, as often as I change my oil, y'all would probably suspect a wrench isn't needed. Now what I've learned on these is when I take these filters off, to go ahead and check my nut here. See how it's loose? Because I just unscrewed the filter. So I just kind of put this in here and snug it back up. You don't want to go too tight because you don't want to break that aluminum. There, that ought to be good. Let me get the filter. Be right back. Okay, now usually there's enough oil sitting right here in the top for me to lube up my rubber. It's just sitting right here. You don't have to put much on there, just enough so that when you tighten it up, your rubber doesn't get all wrinkled. That's all it takes. You don't want a wrinkled rubber. Okay, and that ought to do it. Put this up in here. Oh, and a shout out to Bronco Billy. This is the CarQuest 85797 filter. These are manufactured by Wicks. If any of y'all are wondering why I'm using CarQuest, they are manufactured by Wicks, which is a very good oil filter company, or actually a filter company, period. And that should be tight enough right there. All right, be back in a few. Now I'm going to do something a little bit different on this oil change. I bought a case, which is 12 and three more, because this tractor takes 9 quarts. What I'm going to do this time around, I'm going to put 8 quarts in it, run the engine, let it circulate around, and then flow back down to the pan, shut it off, you know, all that. I'm not going to put 9 in right off the bat. I'm going to put 8 and then check it after it runs a few. Because last time when I put 9, it came too far up on the dipstick. I didn't like it. It was above the safe zone. So I'm going to try 8 and see where that comes out. And so, if, you know, that's what I'm doing. I'm putting 8 in this time and then I'll check it. Maybe it'll be end up being like 8.5. But I certainly don't want to put 9 and have it, you know, too high up on my stick. All right, let's put some oil in. Okay, here we've got the first quart. Customary shout outs to Phil, and shout out to Erica, or Eric. Let me see, shout out to, oh, I'm not going to forget this time, Jason1PA, Brandon, golly, there's a whole passel of y'all over in Pennsylvania. Shout to Ethan. You're not in Pennsylvania, but you could throw a baseball and it'll land in Pennsylvania. You're that close. So, shout out to all of y'all. All right, let me put the other 7 quarts in here and I'll come back.